The record today with 119 degrees came pretty close to the hottest temp ever recorded in Phoenix. That's 122. Today's heat, of course, forcing American Airlines to cancel or delay at least 43 flights in and out of Sky Harbor. New tonight at 6, one Valley woman delayed for hours today after Delta says a heat-related indicator came on in the plane's flight deck at Sky Harbor. That passenger telling us normally it's ideal to fly in sunny skies.
I woke up to sunny weather. I thought I was going to be in Detroit in no time. And so when I see that it's sunny and beautiful to be flying right now, it really isn't because the heat just grounds all these flights.
So today we asked, why can't planes fly when it gets this hot? ABC 15's Mike Pelton joins us now live at Mesa Gateway Airport. And Mike, you got inside a simulator today to see all of these issues for yourself. What'd you find out?
Well, good evening, Stephanie. Today I talked with a former commercial airline pilot who tells me this kind of heat poses the biggest problem for planes during takeoff. As he puts it, every degree makes the plane work just that much harder.
Flap set and we'll just push the power up.
At first glance, you might not notice anything different.
I can see that we're taking a lot longer to build up the airspeed we need to fly.
You're looking at a flight simulator. The conditions, Sky Harbor Airport, 120 degrees.
As we all know from living here in Phoenix, there's warm and then there's hot.
Sure.
And so warm is okay, hot is a problem. Rows of lights off each side of the runway.
Mike Hampshire is a former commercial pilot and instructor with ASU's aviation department. While an extreme example, he says the concern during takeoff is as the air thins and temperatures soar, will too the planes.
And in hot air, you just have to go faster to get as many air molecules to move at the same speed. In addition, your engine performance is reduced.
According to American Airlines, which canceled some regional flights this week, an aircraft's maximum operating temperature is based on manufacturer data. The impacted regional planes cap at 118 degrees, while others are cleared to fly at hotter temperatures.
The airplane itself will fly. There's absolutely no problem at all. But what you're concerned about is if you have a problem. So, for instance, let's say you had an engine failure after takeoff. On a day like today, you might not have the single engine performance to get enough clearance from the obstacles to be safe. So it's better just to cancel the flight.
Now tonight, that instructor tells me not just the temperature, but airport elevation is also an important factor to consider. Now to put this all in perspective, he tells me, of course, this week is going to get a lot of headlines given the high temperatures. Still, that instructor tells me he would rather fly in these conditions than in cold, snowy weather where you have to deal with a slick runway. We're live in Mesa tonight. Mike Pelton, ABC 15, Arizona.
Thanks so much, Mike.